What's up everyone, SuperaTom here, and so our Prince Charming, the genius, the most well-known artist of Tibet. Though his drawings are questionable at times, Albedo is going to come back very, very soon. After a year of disappearance from banners, understandable due to the fact that he is literally went into hiding in the depths of Dragonspine to do his research, now he's back and more powerful than ever. And so today we're going to be looking into the top 5 reasons why Albedo is a must pull for your team in the current meta and even for the upcoming meta. Now before we jump in, I would just like to say that I stream on Twitch mostly on Wednesday and Sunday, so if you're interested, be sure to follow me on Twitch and come hang out. Also, if you find the video enjoyable, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more of my upcoming Genshin Impact contents. And so, without further ado, let's jump into the video. So, number 1, Albedo is hands down one of the best off-field damage support for you in the game right now. Now, off-field damage support characters means that they provide you damage off-field while your main DPS is out there on field crushing mobs. As I always say this to my viewers on Twitch when I do their account review, if you want to have a chance for your account review, be sure to follow me on Twitch also, is that not everything is about your main DPS. Genshin Impact, a lot comes down to how you use your support, because first of all, your main DPS has only one slot, and the remaining 3 slots, you have to wisely choose whichever your support character will be. That's why a team of 4 DPS can never beat teams with 1 DPS and 3 support. Why? Because your support will either provide you off-field damage or boost your main DPS damage, while DPS can only deal damage while they are on field. That's why characters like Xiangling, Xingqiu, Fischl for example are considered to be top tier support, because of their off-field damage support potentials. And this is going to be one of the most important things for you to understand if you're struggling with the Abyss. So, in Albedo's case, his support towards your team is just amazing. His E skill, Solo in Sotoma, has a duration of 30 seconds, while the cooldown is only 4 seconds. So, in other words, his skills has 100% uptime. He creates a geo field, and mobs in this geo field will take AoE geo damage once every 2 seconds. Not only that, his burst has the lowest cooldown in the game, which is 40 energy, and only a cooldown of 12 seconds as well, so you'll be able to spam his burst a lot, which gives him even more damage potential for Albedo and for your team as a whole. Number 2, he is a super free-to-play friendly character, and when I mean free-to-play friendly, I mean like really truly freaking free-to-play friendly, and here's why. His build is based off of his defense, because his E skill scales off of his defense, not his burst however, but since his E skills is one that will help you deal most damage, therefore it's always recommended to build defense on Albedo. So, you know what that means, it's defense artifact guys, literally quote unquote the hardest artifact stats that you can get your hands on in the game. Only someone who's very lucky as me can get my hands on this kind of artifacts almost constantly.
You serious?
5 minutes later.
And that was one of my past videos on my channel, which is something that literally happened during my runs back back. But joke aside, defense is really one of the easiest stats you can build on a character in the game, so you wouldn't really have a tough time with his artifacts build. Not only that, he's really cost efficient to build. To put it simply, character who scales off of defense and HP when leveling up to level 90 will give you better stats increase than those who scales off of attack. That's why normally we don't suggest leveling to 90 as it will cost you a lot without giving too much in return, but for Albedo's case, he's someone that is recommended to build to 90 since he scales off of defense, and that does give him a very, very decent boost. Number 3. Albedo is going to be getting a huge buff in patch 2.3, and you probably already have guessed it, he will be getting his new BIS sword, the Cinnabar Spindle. Literally one of the only weapons that has defense substats for sword up until now, giving a whopping 69% defense bonus at level 90, and it's clearly made for Albedo. Even the passive effect is made for him in that his E skill damage is increased by 40%. The effect is triggered no more than once every 1.5 seconds and will be cleared after 0.1 seconds after E skills deals damage. Now remember that Albedo E skills is triggered once every 2 seconds. This is only 1.5. So in other words, his E skill will always has this effect triggered. So guess what? His E skill is already having at least 100% damage bonus just by holding this sword. And that's just R1. We'll be surely having this weapon to R5 just like the Fest Ring desires. So Albedo's off-field damage now is going to be a freaking beast, and I literally can't wait to test it out once the sword arrives. Number 4, he has access to a lot of artifact sets potential. First two that comes to mind already are Archai Petra, which gives him geo damage bonus and a 35% elemental damage bonus for the team when triggering crystallized reactions. And there's also the Tenacity of Melith. 2-piece doesn't help much, but 4-piece sets help a lot because his E skill is basically on field 100% of the time, therefore being able to get full benefit of this set 100% of the time, which increases the team's attack for 20% and also shield strength for 30%. So even if you don't have an official shield support character in the team, having Albedo there with this set triggering crystallize will already give you a better shield boost already. Not only that, he will also have benefit from the new artifact sets that's coming, which is the Opulent Dreams. We haven't been able to test this on Albedo yet, but we'll do that once it comes out. However, I'm sure that this set will be very good on Albedo, especially when you're looking to have him spam his burst as well, as the 2-piece set gives him a whopping 30% defense bonus. And the 4-piece set, which says that when on-field character gains 1 stack, and the 4-piece set, which says that on-field character will gain 1 stack when hitting opponent with geo attack, and when they are off-field, they will gain 1 stack every 3 seconds, and this stacks up to 4 times, which gives them a 24% defense and geo damage bonus. When 6 seconds pass without gaining any stacks, 1 stack is lost, which means that Albedo have basically 12 seconds of being off field before gaining full stack. And he has another 6 seconds before losing 1 stack. So in other words, he can be off field for 18 seconds, which is more than enough time for you to charge up his burst, pull him out on field to use his burst, and then reset his E skills also. And since his E and burst deal geo damage, he will re-trigger the stack again, which stops them from losing. Now this is all based on theory, however we still need to test this, but I'm sure that this set is going to be very good on him. And then number 5, he is a very easy character to use and can basically fit into any team. That's right, Albedo is literally one of the best off-field supports we have right now, as he can be in basically any team because of his off-field damage potential, especially after patch 2.3, where his skill damage will grow exponentially. He's going to be able to help your team deal a lot of damage in the abyss, even on floors that have many mobs going around. Because his E skill's area of effect is pretty large, therefore even if you don't have character like Sucrose, Venti or Kazuha for crowd control, he'll help you in that spot. You also won't need Geo Resonance with Albedo and can slot in any other resonance of your choice, as Albedo on his own is already good good enough. Again, he's just a very easy and free-to-play friendly character to use. And your DPS will surely have a much better time dealing with enemies whenever he is in the team. So, that's my top 5 reasons why you wouldn't want to miss out on Albedo again on his rerun. Because after patch 2.3, his off-field damage output is literally going to be a beast. We haven't been able to test out, but with such good buff like this, his overall damage output will even be on par with on-field DPS. Plus, after doing a lot of account reviews, I've seen that many of us do need to invest into our support and not just DPS. The reason why you're still not be able to clear the abyss, well, it's the lack of support you have on your team. So if you're considering Albedo or Eula, I personally would tell you to go with Albedo most of the time. But again, the decision is going to be all yours. Well guys, I hope you have found the video helpful. If you did, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for more of my Genshin Impact content. And with that, this is Tom wishing everyone a super day.